gets one started after this. Ready to go? Our starter in this one, Germán Márquez.
Well, there are going to be a lot of balls in play because of the ground ball rate. Important that the defense stays engaged in the game. I think it's critical. Tempo is there. If you work quickly, it helps the fielders behind you to stay engaged, to make those plays, and help you get through the innings.
So just about set. And here is Xander Bogaerts. Now this is in the air down the line. Bryant makes the play. Going up on down. And now it's Juan Soto.
Well, Juan Soto had a huge 2021 season, just 1 point shy of 1,000 for OPS. Absolutely a monster at the plate. This guy's pretty special.
Fires over to Krohn. Quick start here this evening. Two out, top of the first. Here's Manny Machado now. I think the thing you start with for Soto is that patience and that strike zone understanding. A lifetime on base percentage well over 400. In the second half of 2021, he had an OBP over 500. In the air, left field, Bryant under it. And that ends the inning. Nothing doing there for the Friars. The Rockies coming up. We've got no score. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. We go to the bottom of the first. And on the mound for San Diego in this one, Michael Wacha. What's the word on him?
Anytime you have five pitches to work with on the mound, that repertoire can be a real weapon in terms of keeping hitters off balance, man. It's one of those things that I'm going to be looking for in this one. Does he have a feel for all of those pitches, or is he just able to get one or two over in the strike zone where he wants? Now, it's tough to do to be able to command all those pitches, but if he can, he is going to be very tough for the opponent today.
Soto racing over to make the catch. There's Chuck Nasty. The 1-1. That one out to right. Carpenter under it. Brings it in. Two down. Two outs. Base is empty. Here's Chris Bryant now. Two one now. Out towards right center field. Carpenter makes the catch, and that'll do it. Rockies are down quietly. We played an inning, no score. Top of the second, so digging in now for San Diego, Jake Cronenworth. Lifted in the air, right field. Blackman raging back towards the wall. Snags it on the run. One down. So here's the Padres DH, Nelson Cruz. He has consistently been one of the best in the sport against lefties, and yet the righties give him trouble. You know, you don't want to be labeled as that guy, but the numbers say what they say. One down, base is empty. And now it's 3-2. And a pitch. And it's fouled away. Second inning here, no score. And down on strikes. Two gone now.
This guy will throw any pitch at any count. 3-2. He goes off speed, gets the out.
Now it's Matt Carpenter. The wind of the pitch. Fly ball down the line. And that should be extra bases. Makes the turn and heads for second. He's there. It's a two-out double. And it's second here with two away. Now it's the second baseman, Ha-Sung Kim. Here's a 1-1. And a foul ball. Slice to right. And it gets down for a base hit. So that's two straight, two out hits. The tag, and that's out number three, inning over. Padres lead one. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Back here at the ballpark, bottom of the inning, and here is CJ Krohn. The next pitch misses, 2-2. Ricky Holiday, our umpire behind the dish, known as pretty fair umpire for both hitters and pitchers.
Yeah, I think that's right, Boo. There is a little inconsistency on the corners of the plate. You can't always be sure how it's going to go with those borderline pitches as the game progresses.
Next pitch is in the dirt, and now 3-2. Next offering is fouled back. And a pitch. And a pop-up. Right side, foul territory. And there's one away.
Bill, that was a pitch you got to crush. Unbelievable that he missed it right there. And I'm telling you, he is going to be frustrating with himself until his next at-bat.
Ryan McMahon steps to the plate. No score here in the second. And 1-2.
It's a good changeup to hit up in the zone. I don't think he recognized it. I'm sure he'd love to have that one back.
Bounced out to short. Throw over to Cronenworth. Already two out here in the home half of inning number two.
Good fade and sinking action to that changeup. Got that hitter to roll over.
And now here is Elauris Montero. The pitch. Tap back to the mound. Gets him easily, ends the inning. We head on now to the top of the third. We're tied, nothing, nothing. All set for the start of the inning. Here's a speed threat, Trent Grisham. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. Right.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive because there are certain times the ball comes off the bat, automatically that team that hit it thinks that they've got a base hit or they may have extra bases, and he just takes it away.
And the righty deals. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him.
Tell you what, those are the types of guys pitchers really like to punch out when they're on the mound, because if they get on, just the distraction that they create with all that speed over on the base pass, it could take away your focus from the next hitter, and that's the last thing you want to do, is serve up a pitch that a guy hits over the fence and it's a multi-run home run.
Slow roller to first, and he takes it himself for the out. Xander Bogaerts getting ready to hit. Good contact guy, good defender. When you look at Xander, he has all the tools to anchor a World Series lineup.
Yeah, he's one of those rare talents. He's got power at the plate, discipline to go along with it. Oh, and if he gets on, he's got the speed. This guy's a great combo, and he's an RBI machine.
That's the third. Moustakas handles the chance. Zips it across. Bogaerts retired. Third out. Padres down in order. And we're still knotted at zero. Set for the bottom of the third. Here's Mike Moustakas to hit. And a pitch. Fouled off. He was late. 1-2 now. Nope. Chopped out towards short. Tosses across to first. Leadoff man retired here in the third. And now it's Elias Diaz. Right-hander kicks, deals. And that one is lifted in the air. Carpenter has a beat on it and makes the grab. And there's two away. Next for Colorado, Ezekiel Tovar. Two down, nobody on. That catches the top part of the zone. 1-2. And he deals. Stays alive. And a swing and a miss. And that's that.
I think the key is arm action on the changeup. When you can sell it like a fastball, you drop the velocity, you get the swing and miss, and you walk off the field.
New inning getting started, and here is Juan Soto. The wind of the pitch. This one ripped, but foul to the right. And a foul ball, he stays alive. The pitch. And now it's even up. Inside.
Yeah, that's outside.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with the three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
So now 3-2. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. 3-2 now. Ripped on a line to center. Daza makes the grab, and there's one down. Manny Machado, the next up for the Padres. 0-1 with a flyout. Ball to strike. And Manny gets a piece. The 1-2. And Machado able to spoil that pitch. Righty delivers. Stays alive. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. Two quick outs here in the top of the fourth.
Well, that slider wasn't even close to the strike zone, and he got him to chase. That's just a bad approach right there. Either he was looking for something else and got completely fooled, or he was sitting all over the slider and just couldn't resist the temptation. But, man, really expanded right there and didn't have a chance of making contact with that pitch.
And now here is Jake Cronenworth. That's a base hit, and that keeps the inning going.
I really like that swing, man. He didn't just push it the other way through the infield. He drove it that way, and it kind of makes me think he was thinking opposite field as he stepped into the box. Got a pitch he liked, and he got it done. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Cronenworth runs. Pitch in for a strike, and safe. It's a stolen base.
You know, nights like this, when it seems harder to score, I like the call to put him in motion and try to steal the base. Ball's not carrying, no home runs so far, so trying to manufacture some offense like this may be the way to go.
Here's a 1-2. Chases that one out of the zone, and the Padres waste a chance. To the bottom of inning number four now. We're tied, nothing-nothing. Welcome back. And the batter now, Jonathan Daza. The 1-2. That one lifted to left. And there's one down. Here's Charlie Blackmon. The Rockies hitless so far in the game. That one misses in the dirt. One strike. The pitch. That one clubbed out towards left center. That'll be extra bases. And it bangs up against the wall. And that's a double.
Well, when you fall behind in the count, you've got to come into the zone, and then guys have a better chance of hitting the ball hard like he did right there.
So in now for Colorado, Chris Bryant. Popped up to the left into foul ground. That's out number two.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
CJ Krohn digging in for the Rockies. 0-1 so far. Two outs and one in scoring position. Rolled over to third. Knocks it down. And he beats it. That's a hit. Great try there.
Well, that may end up being an at-bat we go back to later on when this game is over. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay. Runner in scoring position now and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
Here's the second baseman, Ryan McMahon. 0-for-1, he grounded out in his first at-bat. Swing and a miss, and that is strike two.
Yeah, I'm surprised we didn't see a visit from the pitching coach here. Just to remind him, focus on the hitter. Don't worry about anything else.
Runners on first and third, two away. On the ground. Takes it to the base for the force out. Inning over. On to the top of the fifth we go. We're tied, nothing, nothing. Ready now for the fifth inning. Stepping in for San Diego, Matt Carpenter. Gonna count 1-2.
Well, a come and get me fastball right there. He didn't look ready for the velocity. I think it'd be a mistake to throw him anything off speed right here.
Next pitch, not close, up high. And now this one's a rocket to right. Way back there. Gone. Matt Carpenter leaves the yard. And just like that, they're out front. It's 1-0.
He's so good at getting his arms extended, and that's exactly what he did right there. You don't typically want to pull a pitch in that part of the plate, but he doesn't allow his wrists to roll over, stays through the ball, gets the lob, and gets the home run.
Next for the Padres, Ha-Sung Kim. Swing and a miss as he was late that time.
Oh, he's just got to delete it. You give up that leadoff home run, go back to work, focus on this next batter.
That one the other way. Makes the catch, one down. Now it's Trent Grisham to the plate. Singy, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. Hard hit, left side. Moustakas whips it to first. That takes care of Grisham. Two outs, base is empty. And now it's Austin Nola. Next one misses, and it's 2-1. The pitch. Swing and a miss. It's 2-2. The wind and the pitch. Good eye in that spot.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
And that one in the air center field. A little bloop single. So a two-out knock keeps the inning alive. So the lineup flips over. Now it's the shortstop, Xander Bogaerts. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Next offering is fouled back. Righty to the plate. In the air, right field. Can't get there, base hit. And now they'll have runners on the corners with two away.
That's back-to-back singles for him. When you pop a ball up like that, you don't expect it to get you a knock too often, but right there, somehow he got it to drop in behind first base, and that's where no one could get to it.
Juan Soto now. That misses the zone.
Yeah, that's ball two.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on. Probably a challenge pitch coming.
Next offering is way upstairs.
A rare three ball count here. He's been throwing strikes all day. Got to be ready to hit if you're in the box.
Left hand batter waits. Now front, pulls that one foul. Now it's 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Got him. Good job at damage control right there.
Well, this guy competes hard. We see the emotion there. I love it. Great job of getting out of the jam.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And now the DH, Elauriz Montero. The 1-1. Called strike right there.
Well, we call that keyholing. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
And that one lifted in the air center field. Grisham settles under this one. And there's one down. Here's the third baseman, Mike Moustakas. That one drilled left field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's two away.
Man, that's one of those at-bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it. But in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at-bat.
The pitch. And a count 1-2.
Now this offense has just been locked down. Almost five full innings of shutout baseball.
Bounce to the right. Kim with the throw to first. Play made. That ends the inning. Nothing doing for the Rockies. They still trail 1-0. And welcome back. Start of the sixth, John Ciambi with Chris Singleton. And leading off, Manny Machado. And the right-hander deals. In there. And so now 1-2. The Rockies have some action in the pen. Justin Lawrence, the hard-throwing righty, is up and loosening. And here it comes. That one down the line. He steps on the bag, and a quick out number one. So now it's the four-hole hitter, Jake Cronenworth, 1-2. The 2-1. And a foul ball.
Some real good life going through the zone on that one.
Line drive, base hit right center field.
Well, they call that an advantage count for a reason. You're so much more likely to get something you can handle. Nice line drive to the pull side, met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
One down. Now the DH for the Padres, Nelson Cruz. High fly ball, pretty well struck out towards right center. That one's carrying. Gone! He powers one out to right field, and they boost their lead. It's 3-0.
Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. Ramon Marquez is done in this one. It's a 3-run game, and we'll be back to tell you about the new arm in a minute. So the Rockies turn the ball over to a new arm, Brent Suter. And his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance.
Well, at this point of the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
So digging in now for San Diego, Matt Carpenter. He's already homered in this game. Next offering is fouled back. The wide to kick the pitch. Now a high fly ball out to left center. Bryant drifts towards it. Puts the squeeze on that one. Two away. Two outs, base is empty. Stepping in for San Diego, Ha-Sung Kim. Hard hit, right side, and that's just foul. And the pitch. Started to swing, held up. Here comes the pitch. Ripped to short, snagged on a bounce. Fires over to first. That ends the frame. Two across on this San Diego homer. It's now 3-0. Back here at the ballpark, now here is Ezekiel Tovar. The Rockies in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at bat out of him right here.
Next pitch is inside, 2-1.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
There's a line drive to left field. Drops in for a hit, couldn't run it down. Into second easily with a leadoff double.
Nice double right there. Loud contact coming off the bat. Didn't get enough air under to drive it out of here, but you'll take that swing and that result every time.
So the Rockies lineup turns over. Next to hit for the Rockies, Yonathan Daza. The 1-1. Swing and a ball hammered left field. That's on its way. Turning, looking, and that one is gone. This place is absolutely loving it. And they cut into the lead. It's 3-2.
This crowd back alive.
Thank you.
That was one of those home runs where you really don't know if he got enough of it off the bat. I mean, he put a good swing on it clearly, but I wouldn't say he really got the sweet spot on the bat. The exit velo wasn't anything too impressive, but it had all it needed for him to circle the pillows.
Now it's Charlie Blackmon. Kicks and deals. On the ground at first, Cronenworth over to pick it up. Steps on first for the out. Chris Bryant gets a chance to hit here.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
And next will be the cleanup hitter, CJ Krohn.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
On the ground, the third might be two. Throws to second for one, and that's two. Rockies edging closer with this shot, and the home team down a run. New arm out of the bullpen, Justin Lawrence. And this guy can bring it velocity-wise. And stepping in is the speedy Trent Grisham.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
Strike two.
One ball, two strikes, account.
Right-handed reliever, and that one missing low. Kicks and fires. Swing and a foul back. That's out of play. At the belt and fires. And now it's filled up.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it.
Bounced up the middle. McMahon gloves it. On the run, sends it over to first. That takes care of Grisham.
Good sinker low in the zone right there and produced exactly what he was looking for. Ball on the ground, nice ground out.
Now at the plate, Austin Nola. That one back up the middle, and it gets through. So the San Diego batting order turns over. Now here's Xander Bogaerts now. Next one off the plate inside. And a count 2-1. And a pitch. Runner on the goal. That's hard hit in the line. And that's a base hit. Just kind of slice that one into center. Save!
Always feels amazing getting a job done when the team needs you to come through. It's just bigger than your own individual stats. Not a bad slider by any means. It was down and away, but an even better job to spoil that thing. And he let it travel, didn't try to hook it. Man, that's a really good approach. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up.
Now the youngster Juan Soto, and a foul ball, he stays alive. Runners at first and second with one gone. And a swing and a miss. That's out number two.
Stood absolutely no chance on that slider right there, and I don't mean to laugh, but that's a tough one. I mean, pretty much a perfect strikeout pitch. I mean, it looks like a fastball middle in, kind of has cutter action, and it just bunches you up to whereas you can't get your hands through and the barrel to it. And not much you can do unless you recognize the spin early and you spit on it.
Here's Machado. And the righty deals. And Manny gets a piece. First and second, two down. Swing and a miss, and that is that.
A couple of strikeouts with runners on. Sometimes you got to really bear down, and he did just that. Nice job of getting out of the jam and out of the inning.
Set for the last half of the seventh. So in now for Colorado, Ryan McMahon. The tying run at the plate. And that one wrapped foul. Looking to get the tying run on base. Tap dances out of the way of that one. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
Oh, just a nice job coming through in a pretty high leverage spot right there. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
And the Padres manager making his way towards the mound as he will make the move. Michael Wacha departs, and as he heads off, we'll step aside for a minute. Back with the new pitcher after this break. Here's a new pitcher from the pen, Steven Wilson, trying to protect this lead. And Lowry's Montero, the next to hit. And a pitch. And that's outside. The count 2-1. Good eye right there.
Well, in this count, runner not known for his speed, but I think you got to put him in motion. Try to avoid a double play here, Boo.
And he couldn't come up with it.
Pretty much the last thing you want from your bullpen arms are free passes, especially in spots like this. Make the team earn their way off.
Now the third baseman, Mike Moustakas. The possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. Nobody out. Next offering misses. 2-1.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
Next offering clips the zone count even at 2. Bullpen action for the Padres. Number 75 getting ready to come in for Bob Melvin. Number 15, a left-hander, also throwing. Swing and a high fly ball. That one out towards left center field, way back there, and forget it. Mike Moustakas goes deep, and the Rockies jump in front. It's 5-3.
That one was a hanger, and pitchers typically don't get away with making a mistake like that. And right there, he made him pay.
And here's the catcher, Elias Diaz. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. And that's the first out. Nice recovery after giving up the homer.
Nice. Doubled up with the slider for that punch out. The one before just caught the zone. So as a hitter, you have to protect right there. Great pitch to just expand a little bit more. He got that chase he was looking for. That right there is good pitching.
Ezekiel Tovar now at the plate. The pitch. In the air on the infield. Kim right there to make the grab, and there's two away. On the ground to the left. To first, that's the third out, inning over. But the big blow of the inning comes right here, a three-run homer. It's now 5-3. Pierce Johnson gets handed the rock out of the pen, and he probably has a little extra in the tank facing his former team. We're at the top of the eighth, and now Jake Cronenworth. The 1-1. That's down and in.
Now you get to this part of the order. Yeah, there's some pop there, but more likely there's some base hits. So very important to be patient. Let the pitcher walk you, if he will.
The 2-1. And a rope into center field, base hit.
Clearly seeing the ball very well in this one. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride and load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
No outs, runner at first. And next is the designated hitter, Nelson Cruz, for the fourth time tonight. The next offering misses, and a count 2-1. Nobody out, runner at first. Hammered down the right side, but foul.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, try to stay out of a double play here.
Oh, and now a wild pitch.
Well, obviously that was nowhere near the strike zone by the time it got to the plate. And people at home watching are thinking, what's he swinging at? But I'll tell you, some of the break guys snap off these days is just devastating. It can be so tough to recognize where a pitch like that's going to end up.
Matt Carpenter, the next up for the Padres. Here's a 2-1. Late that time, and it's strike two. Pickoff throw. Cronenworth gets back easily. Swing and a high fly ball. Pretty well struck right field. That one hops against the fence. The relay to the plate. Save. He scores and it's a one-run game. And it's a one-run game.
Big RBI for him right there. A lot of times in today's game, right fielders are able to get to a ball that stays in like that, but he hit that one pretty well. And if he hits it just a little bit different on the barrel, it's out of here easily. But there's nothing wrong with the extra bases right there.
Ha-Sung Kim digs in now. Man at second. Stays alive.
Well, the hitter's got his timing down for the breaking ball. If you're a pitcher, if you can get that fastball in on the hand, it's going to be very difficult for that hitter to get the barrel to it.
In the dirt, but kept close to third. Tag got him. And a swing and a miss. And that is that. Padres with a run scoring double. It's now a 5-4 ball game. So the Padres with a new arm on the mound, Nabil Crismat. It's his job to keep his team in the game. Welcome back. Bottom of the eighth. Now the number two hitter, Charlie Blackmon. Two and two. Swing and a miss, and he chases that one in the dirt. Beats him for the first out, and that completes the strikeout. Chris Bryant digging in for the Rockies. Two and one now. Activity in the bullpen for San Diego. Tim Hill getting ready to come in for Bob Melvin. And he deals. And a foul ball. He stays alive. The wind of the pitch. High fly ball out into left center field. Soto makes the grab. Out number two. CJ Krohn digging in for the Rockies. Next pitch misses inside. 3-1. Swings through that. Two outs. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four. How big a deal is that walk?
I don't think it's a big deal, because if you pitch to the previous hitter with the power he has, he can hit a home run. I think it was a calculated walk. We'll see how it pays off here.
Next one misses. Two balls and a strike. Right-hander kicks, deals. Fouls one off. 2-2. Right side. Kim collects it. Gets it to first. Out with room to spare, and that's the inning. Through eight full, it's the Rockies 5-4. Daniel Bard gets the call to the mound. He has a great slider with tons of movement. Now a move being made for a pinch hitter, Jose Azucar. A critical at bat in this game for him. The pitch. Got him! And that's the first out.
Well, that right there is what you want to see out of your closer. Come in and close the door, cancel any hope that that opponent has in making some type of comeback in the ball game. Tell you what, that helps him settle in, and that helps everybody else relax a little bit to get these other two outs.
Falling behind 2-1.
Really been able to slow down the game tonight with his at-bats, and the biggest one he's had so far. He doesn't look anxious at all.
One-run game here in the top of the ninth. That one misses, and the count is filled up. Hit on the ground to the right side, and he picks it up and he'll put it in his pocket. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Very close off the outside corner. Could have easily been called a strike in that location.
So the batting order turns over, and here comes Xander Bogaerts. The pitch, and that one a little bit high.
The count is 2-1.
Righty delivers and misses inside.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. Out towards left center. That's got a chance. And that one hops the wall. Throw back in as the tying run holds at third. Two on following the double.
Well, that at bat had a lot of pressure riding on it, so really great job coming through right there. It's got to feel good. Got a good pitch to drive, stayed short with his bat path to the ball and caught it out front, and he stayed long in his follow through. That's how you split the gap, and that's pretty much a double every time. Tying run at third, go ahead at second, so a pivotal matchup coming up.
Calling for the intentional walk, and that loads up the bases. And the force play is now in order. Looks like we've got a substitution at first. Entering is the pinch runner, Adam Engel. Here's Manny Machado, known for his late-inning heroics. One out. The go-ahead run is at second.
Don't be surprised to ball on the ground to the corners that they come home with the baseball instead of going to first base. But I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
Into center. Daza in position. Makes the catch. Here comes the runner from third. Tovar with a relay home, safe at the plate. All tied again, 5-5.
Sometimes all you got to do is your job, and don't overcomplicate things. Keep it simple. Runner in third, less than two outs. Put the ball in play, and a nice job with the sac fly.
Next up is the cleanup spot for the Padres. Jake Cronenworth. Two on, two outs. So a foul ball makes it 1-2.
I want to start that load a little bit sooner because of the good velo.
And that one sliced foul. The 1-2 stays alive. Thank you. 1 and 2 here. And a swing and a miss. Inning over, and it could have been worse.
Sometimes he wears the emotion on the sleeve, but that's okay as long as he's getting results. And right there, thrilled with the punch out to get out of a jam.
Staying in the game on defense, Jose Azucar. He'll be out in center now after pinch hitting. Also into the ball game, Adam Engel. He'll be out in left field. All set for the bottom of the ninth. Here's Colorado's DH, Elauriz Montero. The pitch. Swing and a chopper. And he grabs it in foul ground. Righty to the plate. Swing and a slow roller. Throw over to Cronenworth. One out, bottom of the ninth.
Good arm side run to that same side hitter right there. Very difficult to put that ball in the air or get through it. Just bores in on the hands.
So they're making a move for a bat off the bench. Alan Trejo. One out, the base is empty for him. All tied up here in the last half of inning number nine. And it is 2-1. There's a strike. The wind and the pitch. Ground ball right side. And that quickly, two away. Here's the catcher to hit, Elias Diaz. And a ball and two strikes. In the air, foul off first. Makes the play, and it's out number three. 1-2-3 go the Rockies. This ball game still tied 5-5. So remaining in the game defensively, Alan Trejo. He'll play third after coming into the game as a pinch hitter. Into the game now, the southpaw Brad Hand. On to extra innings. So here's the Padres DH, Nelson Cruz. And a pitch. On the ground to short. That's a base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
No, that at bat had a lot riding on it. Certainly a pivotal swing of the bat in this ball game. Pretty tough for the infielders to do anything with that one. He pulled it hard into the outfield. And even when you keep it on the ground, it feels great when you hit a missile like that.
Go ahead, run on base. Now it's the right fielder, Matt Carpenter. Swing and a miss as he chases that one darting out of the zone. The go-ahead run aboard at first. Nobody out. Line drive caught. Ha-Sung Kim, the next up for the Padres. This is what stat nerds like myself might call a high leverage situation.
Yeah, Boog, not sure what the numbers say, but clearly an at-bat that could change the course of this game dramatically.
Base hit center field. Should be extra bases. Lead runner holds at third, so two runners in scoring position and just one out.
Just a huge at bat right there. Fastball off the plate a little bit, but a really nice job of going with it. Punched it to the opposite field for that knock. Had a huge opportunity now to grab the lead at this point in the game.
Jose Azucar, the next up for the Padres. In the dirt, nothing happening on the bases, though.
In the infield at the corners, don't be surprised to see them come home first and prevent that run from scoring.
And now the lefty, 3-2 now.
Definitely a strikeout situation right here. Lots of ways for that go-ahead run to score if the ball's put in play.
All tied up here in extra innings. Got him looking. Huge strikeout there.
Oh, that's a huge strikeout right there. Big second out. Infield was in. They were playing the full court press, and he got the swing and miss. Keeps this one tied. This next at bat should be a lot of fun. The odds of wiggling out of this just went up considerably.
Here's the catcher, Austin Nola. Of course, little bro Aaron, one of the top starters in baseball. In the air, right field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that'll do it. Padres leave a pair. Our score holds at 5 apiece. Back here in extras, and a new pitcher on the mound in the bottom half of the inning, Drew Pomeranz. Back for the bottom of the 10th, and they'll roll with a pinch hitter to get it started. Harold Castro, he represents the winning run. This to center field, Azucar gets there, he's under it, makes the grab, one away.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
Back to the top of the lineup, and now the center fielder, Yonathan Daza. The pitch. Got him looking, and now two gone.
Well, big strikeout right there, and maybe a little controversial with the call. I think he got a little bit of favor on the mound, no question about it. It's not exactly what you want to see in a big spot like that, and I'm sure there's some chirping going on from the dugout, making it clear that wasn't his best call behind the plate today.
Stepping in, Charlie Blackmon. Swing and a miss, and now 2-2. Slow roller to third, and foul ball. Next pitch misses, and that's ball three. Center field. Great effort as he's able to haul it in, and the inning is over. On to inning number 11 we go. We're all tied up 5-5. Staying in the game on defense, Harold Castro taking over as the new shortstop now following his pinch hit appearance. New pitcher in the game for the Rockies, Nick Mears. And welcome back. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Xander Bogaerts. Hey. 2-1 pitch is in there, and the count is even. Out to short. Castro handles the chance. Not in time. Great effort there, but now the go-ahead run is on at first. The batter now is Adam Engel. The 1-2. Oh, now this one gets away at the plate. Runner holds tight as the count moves to 2-2.
If you're a base runner, you've got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
And a pitch. Got him! And one gone. Manny Machado up to the plate.
If you don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against him.
One away, tie game. Go-ahead run stands at first. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Pretty good spot on the outside, but just couldn't quite clip the zone. That's a stone-cold take.
Jake Cronenworth, the next up for the Padres. In the air, out towards left center. Bryant makes the play, and there's two down. Oh, he throws it away. Next is the designated hitter, Nelson Cruz. He's already homered here in this one. All tied up. We are in the 11th. The next pitch misses, and it's 2-1. Just missed. Little bouncer out in front of the plate, and he grabs it, foul. The kick, the 3-2, and they're all loaded up.
Oh, that sets up a really big at bat in this game. These are the moments when everyone in the stadium gets really locked in.
Two outs, bases full, and now the right fielder, Matt Carpenter. Here comes a pitch. To third. Oh, the throw is wild. Safe at the plate. It's 7-5.
Well, you hate to make mistakes with base runners, whether it's giving up a home run or making an error like that, and it's costly. Two runs come around to score, and sometimes that defense can just tighten up a little bit, get too excited rather than just settling in and making the play.
Pitching change here to Nelson Lamet. He's into the game to face his former team. So two down now, and here is Ha-Sung Kim. That misses the zone. Now 2-2. Got him. That ends the inning, and they limit the damage. Last shot here as we go to the bottom of the 11th. It's the Padres 7 and the Rockies 5. So Josh Hader gets the call to the mound, and he'll do his best to hang on to this lead. back here at the ballpark, all set for the bottom of the 11th. So in now for Colorado, Chris Bryant. And here it comes. And a swing and a miss.
Filthy changeup right there. Just pulled the string.
Laced into left. That's a base hit. Off to a good start with a leadoff dive.
Really nice job of two-strike hitting in that at-bat. Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock. And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
No outs. Runner at first. C.J. Krohn digging in for the Rockies. Kicks and fires. That misses the zone. Now 3-1. Runner at first with no outs here. Swing and a miss, and it's a full count now.
And he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
3-2 now. Ground ball up the middle. Over to Kim. One. How about that double play?
Very smooth on the feed to second right there. You gotta love that glove toss, Boog. You know, sometimes people think these guys are being a little flashy, but it actually can make more sense to do that than try to make a full transfer. And you gotta remember, these guys work on that play all the time, so it's in their back pocket whenever they need it.
Ryan McMahon digging in for the Rockies. Here's a 1-1. And another ball. At the belt and fires. That one fouled off. 2-2. Is just one strike away. See the velocity, 97 with that fastball. In the air, left side, angle. Should have this one, and that'll do it.
Well, I love the fact they didn't quit. They had to do a little extra work tonight to secure this win, but it's what you got to do over the course of a season if you want to be a championship ball club.
A 7-5 final score in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.